All right, everybody, welcome back to another episode of Subnautica. I am Captain Beefy here with the Game Vault. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel and click that bell for notifications. Also, don't forget to leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think so far of the series. Leave a like on the video and share it on social media. Any and all exposure is a huge help to me. Okay, so what are we doing? Last episode was boring, man. All you do is gather stuff together. That's right. And this one's not going to be a lot more exciting, but we're going to have some fun with it. So we need... Actually, unfortunately, we're going to need to gather just a little bit more stuff. We're going to need some table coral. That's something I didn't think of last time. So let's go... find some table coral, because I know we're going to need to build some computer chips and whatnot. And look at this. Here it is already. Okay. So we're going to get kind of a decent amount of this stuff, actually. Just chop all this up. There we go. And let's start picking. Look at that. Okay, perfect. Time to head back home. Now, another thing we talked about was building some power cells, so I know we need... I won't be able to grab a lot of these right now, but get some. We're going to need some silicone for that, so let's grab as many of these as we can. All right, so let's make some silicone rubber. Definitely don't need that much of it, but we're going to pull it as we do need it. There's the silicone rubber. Awesome. Where are we on? A lot of copper. Cool. Yeah, actually, we're going to need... do we have 12 copper in there? Right here. Yep, we got 12 copper. So let's also go get 24 of those acidic mushrooms, because we're going to make a bunch of power cells. In fact, we're only going to make 20. We want 24. We've got... so we're going to need to make 5. All right, so we're going to need 20 of these. Thank you. always in games like this, I love to mass produce stuff. It feels good to be able to do that. All right, so we're gonna need 5 silicone rubbers now. And we just made a bunch of silicone rubbers, so that's perfect. Chips. So let us get rid of some of that gold. What was the other thing we needed for computer chips? Oh, the coral. Of those, I think. Oh, all right, we got too much gold, but that's okay. We'll put the rest back. And while we're at it, we'll just make another copper wire because why not? Okay. It's not the end of the world. Can we even see them from here? Nope, we sure can't. Okay. All right, well, let's put some of this stuff up. Just in case, get that repair tool just in case. All right, the laser cutter. So let us grab some batteries out. Make sure everything is Cyclops there, but we're gonna have to wait. I screwed up. There's a couple other things we want to do by getting those little power chargers set up. That's important because that will help us recharge the Cyclops when it inevitably runs low on power. We will definitely be using that thing fairly extensively. So it won't be too hard to find some rubies. We just got to get down to the right level, which is... Yep, see? Can I already see one? I think two already, right? There we go. So yeah, there's just a little quick trip down. There's one ruby. That's not one. Here's one. Here's another. Do we see any others? Wouldn't mind grabbing an extra while we're here. Here's one. And here's, oh, and there's another. Look at that. So there's a few of them to be had. There we go. Yeah, why not another piece of gold, right? Because we only have 5,000 of them. More rubies. Go. Kind of dime a dozen in this area, aren't they? And then let's do this because why not? All right, back to our little vessel here. Where is it? Oh, there it is down there. Jeez. I'll tell you what, working in a environment like this, it's not hard to get lost. You know, it's kind of good to keep track of where you're going, especially in the dark, you know, when you're down deep in the dark and you've kind of wandered around from one area to the next. Yeah, it can get a little crazy. There's a couple more interesting plants. Yourself, why are you doing that? And one of the reasons is, you know, we've gone a distance away from our base. So we're finding some interesting plants that we don't have around it that are found in a different biome, deeper waters and whatnot. And I'd like to grow them in my garden. That's pretty much simply it. So we'll go in and plant these things and put down a couple more plots if we have to. Down and get one of these too while we're at it. Oop. That doesn't work. This will. Okay. this is where snap on points would be great if we had a little snap points, but we don't, so it is what it is. You might say, well, why only get one of each? Why not gather a bunch so you can fill these up immediately? Well, as you can see, seeds and cuttings take quite a bit of space up in your inventory, so in doing it like this, I'm able to bring back a bunch, and later on I can pick them or tear them up or whatever it is to put down more. Alright, so I got 6 rubies. I need 6 titanium and 3 advanced wiring kits. So advanced wiring kits are, I need 5 more gold, 3 wiring kits, and 3 computer chips. So we'll put them up. Alright, computer chips, where are you, buddy? Did I not make those? Here they are. Okay, so advanced wiring kits, I need 2, 4... 6 of these, I believe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The different levels required to build stuff is kind of a pain in the butt. Oh, I need another gold. Remember when I was complaining about all that gold? Not anymore, baby. Alright, so advanced wiring kits, rubies, and titanium. Start by taking this off the wall because it's empty. And just like that, we can go in here and place 3 of these down. Bigger than the regular battery ones. But, you know, the power cells are bigger, so it is what it is. I mean, each only hold 2. The Cyclops holds 6 power cells. So now we have enough power cells to fully reload the Cyclops if we run it out of power. And that is golden. Okay. So, putting on the ship, we're going to need a gold, a table coral, and a titanium. Copper. There we go. We're gonna need copper. copper wire and a wiring kit. All right, let's get that set up. Chip again, we need gold, copper wire, and a table coral sample. Fiber mesh. All right, we've got 10 more of those. And we're going to start building on the Cyclops now. Shooby-dooby-doo. See what we got here.
Welcome aboard, Captain. All systems online.
All right, so let's go up here first. And this room is probably a good room to put some of this stuff down. So, do a radio here. Do a fabricator. Man, I'm short a table coral sample and a silver ore. Crap. All right. Well, we definitely want one of these up here. That'll be for stuff related to the ship. And then we're going to put one in here. Actually, I'm going to take that one down. And we will put it in here. This will be for gear that we want to maybe trade out and all that, like our radiation suit and whatnot. Put an indoor grow bed in. Nice big one instead of those smaller ones. And what did we need? We needed a we can do a battery charger. Alright, so let's pop a battery charger down in here too. So for this we needed a table coral sample and then we needed a silver ore. Okay. Well, we were in pretty good shape. Back to the ship. One thing I'd love to build on here, but we can't, is the water filtration system. That's unfortunate. All right, but here we got a lot of our basics, right?
Cool.
All right. Now we're gonna go down here, and we're gonna start building some. They can be stacked too high. Look at that, we jammed in six of them right here, right? I don't quite line up against the wall, but who's looking? So that's cool. But yeah, we'll be able to put a lot more in as time progresses and the need arises. All right, so let's go down. Couple of them are almost grown, but mostly not. Okay. Go ahead and place that in there. And let's get the plants we want. Let's get these seeds growing. I like the marble melons just because they're very versatile, as they provide a decent amount of water and food. So having 16 of those growing, that's a good thing. Off all these lantern fruits. As you can see, I kind of mix it up as far as what plants I use to eat and all that. But these marble melons are great. They are probably the most versatile of the different foods. Now this bulbo plant does pretty good too. Let's go ahead and chop it up. I'll show you what this provides. Eight food and 10 water. So that's another good one to have. Come on, little fellas. Thank you. is growing now. Growing. And what else do we really need? Let's take a quick look through everything. I guess we could do an aquarium, but it's not really necessary. We can't do any of this stuff, unfortunately. That's needed. I could put like a little bed in if I wanted. Trash can, that's something I definitely need to build. Could put in a vending machine, you know, stuff like that, counters and all that. Decorative stuff, but we really don't need any of it right now, so we're not going to. Do, however, is go down in a cave bush. Can't get some jelly shrimp. Not sure if this is anything here. Yeah, I didn't think so. Okay, let's go on back up. Good. All right, so other than the jelly shroom, we've got all of our planners filled up. Look how wonderful all that is. I guess we could put down a couple more foundations, two lead and two titanium a pop, right? Let's look at throwing down three more of those, because it'll make for a bigger and better. It'll add integrity to the base, so that's important. See, we got our whole strength up to 10.5 now. That'll add for a larger garden area. We'll be able to expand it this way a little bit and make it a lot nicer looking. So, good deal there. Let them go. Seamoth is loaded up, repaired, and ready to rumble. And our health, food, and water are in good shape. There is that. Okay. So, we have built up our Cyclops a little bit, gotten it equipped with some of the basics, and, you know, all the stuff we're really going to need to rock and roll and get around for a bit. I think what we're going to do next is take that ship over to the Altera, and we're going to explore the Altera. It should be a fun mission. There's a lot going on that. There's a lot going on that ship. So we're going to come away with quite a few items. We might have to make a trip or two out and back in. If I remember correctly, we're going to need that. There we go, the propulsion cannon. So a wiring kit, a battery, and titanium. So yeah, let's go ahead and make that if we can. Acidic mushrooms, we should be growing them by now. So that's something we're gonna do. You know, while we're out, we'll also do that. Okay. So let's go back. It looks like we hurt ourselves too. Situations where you are facing a bunch of boxes that are blocking your way and stuff like that, and the propulsion cannon will just blast them out of your way and give you a little bit more room to get around, so that's a huge help. Batch of mushrooms growing. Everything else is looking good. Yeah, not really sure what hit us there, but got us pretty good. We're going to go ahead and wrap up this episode of Subnautica. I am Captain Beefy, and I'm here with the Game Vault. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel and hit that bell for notifications. Don't forget to leave a like on the video and comment on it. Let me know what you think of the series so far. And don't forget to share us on social media. Every bit of exposure helps. We're sitting at about 13 subscribers. I'd love to get that number up to 25. That'll be a big number for me. I know it's not much, but if each and every one of you gets one more subscriber for me, it will be surpassed. Thank you very much. We'll see you next time, and stay dry.